myocardial infarction. This is also called as heart attack. Here, there is death of cardiac muscle due to prolonged ischemia for more than 20 minutes. Risk factors of myocardial infarction. 10% of cases occur in people less than 40 years of age, 45% in age greater than 65 years, and the predisposing factors, the main is atherosclerosis. And the myocardial infarction is more common in males than in females because the females are protected by the hormone estrogen. Let's now see the pathogenesis behind myocardial infarction. First, this is a coronary artery where there is an atherosclerosis plaque. When the plaque gets activated, it leads to platelet adhesion and aggregation. The platelet adhesion forms microthrombi. And the platelet adhesion and aggregation leads to the release of mediators like cytokines, which induce vasospasm. So this is the pathogenesis behind myocardial infarction. Next, the events in ischemic cardiac myocytes. So firstly, within seconds, the depletion of ATP starts. So the ATP becomes 40% in 10 minutes and 10% in 40 minutes. This is important. So 40% in 10 minutes and 10% in 40 minutes. And the irreversible injury starts within 20 to 40 minutes. This is a simple graph representing the decrease of ATP over time and the increase of lactate production in the myocytes. The progression of myocardial necrosis. This is a section of myocardium which is normal. So this is the coronary artery, myocardium, and this is the endocardium. This area shown in orange color is the subendocardium. This area is the least perfused area in the myocardium. So this is more prone to myocardial necrosis. When the coronary artery is obstructed, this is at 0 hours, that is at the time of obstruction. After 2 hours, this is the zone of necrosis, that is the subendocardial region, as it is the least perfused area. And when the time progresses to 24 hours, the whole thickness of the myocardium undergoes necrosis. This is called as subendocardial necrosis, and this is transmural infarction. So the black thing is the zone of necrosis. The myocardial infarction is divided into three types: subendocardial infarction, transmural infarction, and multifocal infarction. The subendocardial infarction occurs when there is partial coronary artery occlusion. Here, the least perfused area gets affected. So, the least perfused area is subendocardium. That's why this is called subendocardial infarction. Next is transmural infarction. Here, there is complete obstruction of the coronary artery. Transmural means the entire thickness of the myocardium gets affected. Multifocal infarction, here there is occlusion of small intramural vessels. So the coronary arteries are not affected here. So in this case, microinfarcts are seen. Let's now see the different areas of heart affected when different arteries are occluded. First, when there is occlusion of left anterior descending artery, as this artery supplies the left anterior surface, this area is affected. And the left anterior descending artery, called as LAD, is the most common artery involved in myocardial infarction. Next, left circumflex artery. This is the left circumflex artery which supplies the left lateral surface of the heart. So when this artery is occluded, the left lateral surface is involved. Next is posterior descending artery. This is posterior descending artery which supplies the posterior surface of the heart. So when there is occlusion in this artery, the posterior surface gets involved. Right circumflex artery. This is the right circumflex artery which supplies the lateral surface of the heart. So when this gets occluded, the lateral surface of the heart is involved in myocardial infarction. So these are the four main arteries involved. Let's now see different types of infarcts. First, this is the normal heart. Right ventricle, left ventricle, the posterior descending branch, left circumflex branch, and left anterior descending branches of the coronary arteries. First, let's see the three transmural infarcts. Posterior descending branch occlusion. So the posterior descending branch of the artery is occluded, which leads to infarction of the posterior surface of the heart. Next, left circumflex branch occlusion. This is the left circumflex and this is occluded. So there is transmural infarct of the left surface of the heart. Next, LAD occlusion. This is the major artery to get occluded. So this leads to the transmural infarct in the left anterior surface of the heart. Next, small intramural occlusions. Here the coronary arteries are spared. There is occlusion of small intramural vessels. So these are the micro infarcts seen. Circumferential subendocardial infarct. Here the three vessels are not completely occluded, but they are partially occluded. So there is subendocardial infarct, as mentioned. Subendocardial infarct. Circumferential because it involves the whole of the myocardium. Next is transient or partial obstruction. In this partial obstruction of the left anterior descending artery, there is partial infarct of the anterior surface of left ventricle. So these are the different types of infarct seen. Let's now see the morphological changes in myocardial infarction. They are of two types, reversible and irreversible changes. First, reversible changes, which start occurring in 0 to half an hour. So the changes seen here are grossly, there is no change observed in 0 to half an hour. Light microscopy also there is no change. Whereas in electron microscopy, there is relaxation of myofibrils and loss of glycogen along with mitochondrial swelling. These are the reversible changes seen in the electron microscopy in 0 to 30 minutes. So there is relaxation of myofibrils, loss of glycogen and mitochondrial swelling. And grossly, the areas of necrosis are seen by using TTC. That is triphenyl tetrazolium chloride. So here the changes become visible in 2 to 3 hours. So this stains the lactate dehydrogenase, which is rich in normal myocardium. So the normal myocardium appears brick red in color when stained with TTC. Whereas in infarcted myocardium, as it is deficient in LDH, it does not stain that parts. So those parts in which there is infarction, pale yellow in color. So the normal myocardium appears brick red color and the infarcted myocardium appears pale yellow in color when stained with TTC. triphenyl tetrazolium chloride in 2 to 3 hours. The irreversible changes associated with myocardial infarction at different times. First, in half an hour to 4 hours, there is no gross change. In light microscopy, there is waviness of fibers. This is the first feature seen under light microscopy, which is irreversible change. And in electron microscopy, in half an hour to 4 hours, there is sarcolemmal disruption and presence of mitochondrial amorphous densities. Next, in 12 to 24 hours, grossly there is dark mottling. Light microscopy, we can visualize pycnosis of the nuclei. And in 1 to 3 days, grossly the heart starts appearing yellowish. Light microscopy, there is loss of nuclei along with neutrophilic infiltration. In 3 to 7 days, the heart becomes yellow and it gets softened. And light microscopy changes are, there is macrophage activation and phagocytosis. In 7 to 10 days, the heart starts turning red in color, and in light microscopy there is granulation tissue formation. In 2 weeks, grossly the heart starts scarring, and light microscopy there is collagen deposition. And after 2 months, the scarring gets completed, and in light microscopy it can be visualized as dense collagenous scar. So these are the irreversible changes seen grossly under light microscope and electron microscope at different time intervals. Let's see about the enzymatic markers of myocardial infarction. Most common markers are cardiac specific troponin T and troponin I, referred to as CTNI and CTNT, and CKMB, that is creatine kinase MB, but this CKMB is also present in skeletal muscles. So the CKMB is sensitive but not specific to MI, as its level can be increased even in skeletal muscle injury. So CKMB is sensitive but not specific to MI. The CKMB starts to rise in 2 to 4 hours, peaks at 24 hours, and then it comes back to normal in 1 to 3 days with an average of 72 hours. Next, troponin T and troponin I, these also start to rise at 2 to 4 hours, peak at 24 hours, and come back to normal in 5 to 14 days, average 7 to 10 days. Next is myoglobin. It starts rising in half an hour to 2 hours, peaks at 4 to 6 hours, and comes back to normal at 24 hours. So when these two are at peak, the myoglobin comes back to normal. This is a graph representing this information. The pink line is cardiac troponin T and cardiac troponin I, which start to rise at 2 to 4 hours, peak at 24 hours, and then they come back to normal in 5 to 14 days with an average of 7 to 10 days. The violet line is myoglobin, which starts to rise in half to 2 hours, peaks at 4 to 6 hours, and comes back to normal in 24 hours. The green line is CKMB, which initiates to rise in 2 to 4 hours, peaks at 24 hours, and then comes back to normal in 1 to 3 days with an average of 72 hours. So this is all about myocardial infarction. Thank you.